Hello there, welcome to this fifth episode of Drawing with Dona-Pier. So today the main subject for the video is gonna be the seven deadly sins. Not the anime, because I haven't watched it, but the seven sins from the religious books, which are pride, greed, wrath, envy, lust, gluttony, and sloth. I have to be careful on how I say sloth, with my not so perfect English accent, it can turn into a sloth pretty quick. So for today's video, the drawing is gonna be a little bit abstract, but I hope you'll be able to see the subject behind it. So I'm gonna start with wrath, because it's the one I started the drawing with. And what I'm gonna do, I believe, is I'm gonna speak about the seven sins, and I'm gonna tell if I have the sin or not. I think in general, like every human, like I have all of them, but some of them are more obvious than the others. Wrath, by example, is one of the sins I have. It's not obvious when you listen to the video, you hear me speaking. I sound pretty relaxed, and it's something like a lot of people tell me I look relaxed, but it's more like a mental thing. Wrath comes from, I'm easy to trigger, but like I do have a sense of respect, so I don't get into argument easily. But it's like I say, it's a mental thing. Like in my head, I really am angry about life. I don't know. It's just because there are so many stupid people, and sometimes like I feel like my wrath comes from the fact that I feel like the people don't listen to me often, and they go with their belief, and then you say something, but they don't. They will listen, but they won't listen. Like they just get their idea, and it's impossible to change them. And sometimes it's obvious that there's a problem. I have the solution, but the people don't listen to me because I'm not confident when I speak. So they do their mistakes, and then they're like, what should I do? Like, oh, this doesn't work. So what should I do? And I'm like, I told you what you should do, and I'm out of this project. So I have this angriness inside of me. I am a very angry person. I think that's enough with wrath. Yeah, the thing with the sins, what I read yesterday quickly on Google, is that those sins are the ones who supposedly they will be the most the ones that drags other people into the sins. So when you're angry, you get people to be angry also around you. Which to me it's not such a problem, because it's all in my head, so people don't notice. But when you express this sin, like as soon as you get angry, you get mad at someone, he gets mad also, and it just gets the whole situation much more worse. So if you think about pride, greed, envy, lust, gluttony, to me, it's not obvious that they drag other people into the same sins. I think wrath and sloth are gonna be like, if I say, oh, we're gonna do that tomorrow, the other person's gonna be okay, let's do this tomorrow. It's true that it's easy to follow the sin. After wrath, I started drawing, I believe it was greed, which I don't have greed. This is not one of my sin. Like seriously, like we're having this, we are in quarantine for the COVID-19 again. And greed, like in Canada, we have the PCU, which is an urgency. They give money to people who has lost their work. And like, I almost didn't ask for the PCU, which is... for 4 months, it's like $8,000. So, I get it. I asked for the PCU. I did ask for the PCU, but for a moment I thought like do I really need this money? Like we're gonna have to pay our taxes after that. But like so you see like I'm not very greedy. Like of course it touches me. Like of course I want money or at some point, but it's not something like I know that if I get rich, I'm gonna get my money to be useful for people around me and not all just for me. After that, the other drawing, I think it was a gluttony. Gluttony. This to me is a phase. It's sometime yes, sometime no, but I think mostly yes. I eat a lot. Like people don't believe me when I say I eat a lot. 'Cause I'm tall, but I'm super slim, and I have friends who are overweight, and they look at me eating, and they're getting mad at me because they eat as much as me, and they're getting overweight, and me is just I keep eating food all day, and I stay slim, I stay fit. We had this party where we were eating a fondue, and everybody had finished. And there were a lot of leftover, and I was like, we can't let all this leftover on the table. So people all stopped eating. They all started the party, and me was still there eating the fondue for like an hour after everybody stopped eating. So it's just it's incredible how much I can eat food. Recently, I'm starting to eat a little bit less. Like I have difficulty with my digestion. When I wake up in the morning, like my belly hurts, so I'm starting to eat a little bit less. And as I'm growing older, I think it's gonna be a sin that's gonna disappear. But I don't see it as a sin. Like I eat a lot of food when there is a lot of food. But if I go at someone's place and there's food, I'm not going in the food and trying to steal food. But it's true that I don't like wasting food. Envy is one of the principal character in the Brotherhood series with the Elric brothers. How it's called again? It's the Full Metal Alchemist. Envy reminds me of Fullmetal Alchemist. We see this character a lot in the series. It's annoying. It was a pretty good manga. If you like manga, like it talks about the seven deadly sins, and there is two versions. One is more related to the Bible, and the other I don't know what happens. It turns out into a weird situation. And they are the seven deadly sins, which represent some characters. And I really like the series. I like how they build up. At first, like the first 20 episodes are childish, so it annoyed me. I didn't like the 21st episode, but there are some parts that are very dark, and it feels it's like it's childish, but they are very mature content, and you're like, whoa, what's going on there? And then in the end, there's a war that. It gets prepared, and it's kind of crazy. I like how it builds up. I recommend it. It's not the best manga, but it's worth watching it. And Envy, I believe this scene represent. I want the power. I want everything. I want what the other have. And it's like in The Simpsons, this episode where Lisa tries to prove Bart that people want things that they don't own. So she gives a balloon to like the baby have a balloon. Maggie Simpson have a balloon. She doesn't play with it, but as soon as Lisa takes it, like Maggie start asking for the balloon. She wants it. So this is Envy, and then Bart want the ball also. So this I don't think I have this sins. Again, it's a little bit of a mental thing. Like right now, I have this project of building a house, and the model I have is tiny. And then I work in the construction, and I'm building this house. I'm not building the house, but like the foundation. and it's huge. Like it's 5 times bigger than the house I want to build for myself. And then of course, like I have this little thought of I want this. Like how? Why is this guy having this and not me? But it gets away pretty quickly. I have this sense of like I have to work. I think this is why I don't have this sense, is because I want to work for what I have. I don't like when I own something and I haven't worked for it. I want to work for what I have. So envy, of course, I have these little thoughts sometimes, but it quickly comes to my mind, like what is the work I have to do for this? What are the sacrifices I have to do for this? And I'm not very materialist, so I don't need much to be happy. I think I am grateful for what I have. I'm thankful for this. And the less you have, the easier it is to get away. So, for example, I live in Quebec, and I moved to Nova Scotia when I was younger, and then I had not a lot of things, so it was easy for me to just go away, take the car, and go away. So, no, envy is not one of my sin. After that, I think it was a sloth. So this word I think I have some difficulty to say it. Sloth, sloth, sloth. Sloth, sloth, sloth. Okay, so this word. So this word, this word, that thing, sloth. This sleepy thing. It's an animal, the sloth, and it's a pretty lame animal. Its best defense is to not move, because if it doesn't move, then the predator don't know that it's alive. So that's pretty sloth. I don't think this is one of my sin. Again, with the when I moved to Nova Scotia, I got to this apartment with five other guys, and the whole place was a mess. There was like rat shit everywhere, and I'm the one who cleaned all the place. I repaired the door. The one door was broken for the bathroom. So, and I started like the landlord was always bringing stuff that she got from the trash bin. And I try to take all this stuff and make the apartment look pretty. So I don't think this is one of my sin. But when it comes to things that I'm afraid of, I don't know. There I'm gonna be procrastinated more. So basically, I work hard when it's for things that interest me or things that are OCD, I think, obsessive compulsive disorder. And so when it comes to my OCD, I work a lot. So cleaning the house and stuff, I will do it, putting all in order. But then when it comes to something I don't like, quickly I'm gonna go like, oh, let's do this tomorrow. Because it takes me a lot of energy just to make a phone call. I don't like to do phone call. I'm stressed. It stressed me out. I don't know why. Yeah, I don't like this. I always feel like when I speak to someone, I am taking his time, and I feel bad for the person, so I don't want to disturb anyone. So, when I speak to the phone, I'm trying to make it quick, and then I forgot the question I want to ask, and then I get so nervous, and it's just not fun for me. So this is why I will procrastinate these kind of tasks. And then I'm gonna go for pride. I draw these arrow going back and forth, because I think pride is pretty much what it is. It's everybody's agree for something, and there is this one guy who is too proud of his own idea, and he goes against everyone, so he's going backward. So these arrows are going forward, and this guy is going backward, pushing everybody back because of his pride. Again, I don't think this sins belongs to me. I do have a little bit of pride though, so sometimes it's hard for me to go back on some ideals. But recently, I want to build my house, so I was looking for a house, some plans. So I wanted to draw mine. So I draw my house. I draw all the separation inside everything, and then I got to talk to an architect who will draw the plan for me. He made a submission for how you think the house would cost me. It was way more expensive than what I thought. And then I had this pride, like this sense came to my mind where I'm like, no, I'm not wrong. It's gonna cost less than this. And I want to build this model anyway. But then I swallowed my pride. I was like, no, this is gonna be too much expensive. And I'm just gonna go to the model I wanted at first. So I saw a model on the internet, which is smaller than what I wanted. This is something that would explain, like, I don't have pride. I think pride is one of the hardest subject to talk about, because pride is something about, there is something about logic behind this. So intelligence, like you could confuse pride with stupidity, because sometimes, like, you have an idea, one of us is wrong, but if you believe that you are right, like, it's not pride, it's just you believe you're right, like you follow your logic, and if it makes sense to you, then why should you go to the other person's perspective? Because in your head you're right. So you have to understand. I think pride comes when you have all the when you have the proof that what you're doing is wrong, but you still do it. This is pride. If you believe you're right, you are wrong, but you believe you're right, and you don't have the proof that you are wrong. So there's no way for you to swallow your pride. You just don't know. Like, you believe you're right. So pride is kind of hard to observe because of this. And sometimes, like, this is where I want to go, is that sometimes, like, how you want to improve in society, you have to push your ideas. So, for example, Einstein, who wants to prove his relativity concept, which is, it's insane. Like, it's one of the, like, if you haven't read his book, this guy is crazy. He's going to a very, very far opinion, which is not the popular opinion. He just thinks about stuff that are so crazy, and people would look at him and say, "What are you doing? You're crazy," and blah blah blah. And people would think that this guy is proud and that he's trying to push his idea, which looks wrong. But then he proves everybody that he's right in the end. So it was not pride. It was like this guy was just smart. It was like crazy insane. And I think pride is, like, you have to be able to see what is pride and what is logic. Pride is something that you have to be cautious. Like, you don't have to blame pride if you're not sure 100% that this is pride or stupidity or smartness. And then after pride, there is lust. Lust is one of my sin. Yeah, it's funny because this one is like, when people look at me, they won't think of that. But if you go on my Instagram, you will see, like, recently I posted a lot of drawing there that would suggest that lust is one of my sin. I just love girl, like, what can I say? How can I defend myself with this? Because this is a taboo. Like, if we look at it the way, like, my grandfather was seeing, like, sexuality, and it's weird to talk about my grandfather and how he sees sexuality, but our elders, it's weird to see our elders, like, people who have more than 100 years, they will see sexuality like something bad because they were told it was bad. which is not logic. It's just people tell you it's bad and they have no reason for it, but they do believe it, and they're trying to tell us that it's bad. So as soon as like people would like watch porn and do sodomy, like they would be like sinners. With the modern society, I think lust is not a sin anymore. In fact, it would become a sin when people are harassing people, like sexual harassment, pedophiles, rape, and incestuous behavior. Like just showing off your penis to strangers. This when you write this on paper, it's funny, but when you do it in real life, it's not funny anymore. Like, you have a problem. And there it's when this is where you become a sinner. But I think there are some behavior that are kind of normal. They are not normal, but they are on the edge, and like you could lost your job for this, which happened to a guy called Joël Lejeune in Quebec. Like, he masturbated in a park and he got caught. So this is not normal. But in the end, his goal was not to show his dick to people. His goal was to not being caught. This is where the guy gets his excitation. And in the end, I think like human, they didn't have lost their sense of wilderness. Like everybody have sex in their house. But I think that everybody wants to have sex in the forest, have sex in their car. And I don't think this is a sin anymore. But it's something that it's taboo. Like, people, they don't want to catch you doing this. But people don't want to get caught. You have a problem when you want to get caught. When you're imposing your sexuality to people. Like, sexuality shouldn't be forced to others. Sadly, some people don't understand this. If you want to have sex in the wilderness, like, be sure not to get caught. But in a philosophical point of view, I don't think there is something wrong to this. But it's on the edge, pretty much on the edge. It's a taboo, that's it. Don't get caught. No, but I talk about this because I see that these behavior exist, and I see that the society is going into something where sexuality is more and more open, and there is this edge I talk about, like where people don't understand the limit of don't get caught and don't force others to your pleasure. Like, don't go and show off your dick to strangers. Don't go and show off your vaginas to strangers. I do believe that guys will not feel like they are a victim of this, but I do feel there is a difference between a guy showing his dick and a girl showing her vagina, but still it's kind of a disturbing behavior. So be careful there. I see that this society is going into this much more than before, more than ever. And I think that this is what ends the discussion here. So the morality of the story is don't show your dick to a stranger. I hope you had a fun time listening to me. Today was a little bit more funny than before, and I like this. This is completing my drawing. I hope you can tell where are the sins in my drawing, and I hope you like the drawing. I hope you like the discussion, and I see you on the next episode. Thank you again for watching, and bye bye.